Welcome back to The Vibe. Real masters of traditional Chinese operas will make the most acrobatic feats look like a cinch and no sweat. But even the simplest poses and movements take decades of strenuous training. Now, sending one student to train as a traditional Chinese opera actor was usually a last resort for families scraping to make ends meet. Today, that is no longer the case, and Chinese operas are finally enjoying the prestige, the result of all the hard work in the past being paid off. And it has attracted one diehard fan, U.S.-based Nadim Diab, to learn the basic skills of Pekin opera. Donning the traditional training clothes, Nadim has challenged multiple Pekin opera physical practices, from leg skills, waist skills, and cloud hands to even the eye expression. The strict requirements from his mentor has given him some hardships during the training. Yet as his training pain wears off, is he any closer to getting to the essence of this traditional Chinese culture? Take a look.
Today was quite interesting because I got to sit down and watch two rehearsals. One in the morning about a Wenxi, which is a civil play, Suo Ling Nan. The other one in the afternoon was a Wuxi, which is a military play, and it was Long Feng Cheng Xiang. And it was interesting to actually go through this experience because even though that on my very first day here, I did watch a live play by Di Cheng, but that was me sitting with the spectators. Here I get to be among everyone, and I was so very close to the stage that I could see them even more clearly. It did start very strong. I was very interested, and I was keeping my eyes open and my ears open to everything that was happening around me. So all of these, I was trying to pick up a few tricks, a few notes from them. I sort of, my brain overheated and it needed to cool down with a quick nap. I am extremely excited this is happening. The first couple of days were only introductory, but today I'm more excited because today is the day that we start learning. All of these people who are, you know, coming together and combining all their efforts to help me, I cannot wait to actually get it started, and today is the day. This is when it's happening. Zhi Lao Shi,
Ni hao.
And then today, when I saw him in the rehearsals, he was more in the background. He was one of the very supporting actors. And not even that, I think in the movie industry they would call him an extra even, just because he didn't have any spoken words. He was just there to complete the scene. And I thought that was quite interesting.
我们京剧啊讲究一颗菜的精神。什么叫一颗菜呢? 就像, 白菜棒一样, 就是团团的抱在一起。 我们虽然说京剧是角儿的艺术, 但是红花还得绿叶衬。 光有红花不行，还得有绿叶。那咱们准备开始吗？对，我们学习之前啊，我们要先练功。我们前一两年都是不教剧目的，都是要先练功的。咱们这时间比较短，我们就是咱们先上几节课，然后再学剧目，好不好？
好，OK。
就是我们有一句老话呀，叫戏好学功难练，就是说呢，我们学一段戏好学，但是没有功夫演出来就是。 我们讲话白开水，就观众也不会愿意去看。我给他制定的这个规划要先从练功开始，先从最基础的基本功，腿功、腰功，各种技巧的功夫开始，然后我们再涉及剧目片段，最后再到两个人的配合，呈现出一个完整的演出的一个片段。
还有一个事情啊，就是我们练功之前啊，要换练功服。白球鞋、灯笼裤，还有一个宽松的T恤就可以了。然后，最重要还需要一个板带。这个就是我们练功用的板带。对，然后要稍微勒得紧一点，要起到一个提气的作用。
对，
然后还可以保护你的腰部，腰部肌肉。我们行话叫内练一口气。练功的时候要记着它。
保持这口气，
每一次
都是要。那我们今天就先穿这个暂时练，
然
后下次的课把它背齐了。
嗯，
好，我们今天啊先教压腿，
压腿
我们有三种，一个是压正腿、压十字腿，还有压旁腿。
OK，
啊，我们一个一个来，好吧？先教压正腿。
OK，
对，要脚后跟啊放在这个上身，能下到最低的程度，
嗯，
算一下，摆齐一、二，对，四、五，我们现在要抱着脚去够脑袋，去够脑袋，
啊、不会吧？
再压十下，预备，起，一，好，还有一点啊，为什么让你压它呢？就不让你弯膝盖，哎，让你上来压下去，哎，再教一个叫十字腿，
十字腿，
哎，就现在压了左腿吗？往你的右前方放，主要就是撑的这个肌肉，
对，
六，
烫是在这儿，
对。
There were a couple of times when he was like, do not put your foot down. And I was so tired that I needed to put my foot down. But it's a guiding, it's a custom that you have to finish the move. There's no escape. I wanted to quit at times, so he was very strict about it that you have to do it. And I think that that's tough love.
为什么要练腿呢？就是做任何动作，都是需要步伐腿来带动的啊，所以你腿压好了，身上才能好看，动作才能漂亮。
好的，
明白吗？
可以。
二，对，预备，起，一，好的，踢完了还绕回原地啊，
好，
还绕回原位。
Okay.
二，好的，对，九，十。上步踢腿，啊，走，好的，不错啊，踢十字腿，前面就一样，去踢你的斜上方，在这
儿，
啊，这边也是斜上方，在这边，
好的，但是好不容易做，因为我觉得我做这样动作的时候，我觉得我没有这个 balance。
绕回原地，别不敢绕，
嗯，
就绕回去，绕回去，对，就绕回去，对，就绕回去。
这个好难，
踢腿，对啊，来，
这个动作我觉得是
有点难，
最难，
有点难，
最难
啊，
哎，
对，变手，踢腿，好了，好，我们休息一下，
好。
刚才教了三种腿，这是第四种，叫踢片腿。
踢片腿，
哎，上步的时候两个手就变平了，哎，这是什么用呢？这个腿啊要片到手上，片一个大圆圈，哎，要从十字腿起，从上面画一个圆圈，有点力量。好的，这就找着范儿了，
哎，
明白吗？踢完了赶紧落地。
OK。
五，快点快点快点！啊，一开始啊，我还是很担忧的啊，因为毕竟零基础的啊，这个学员就学习武戏是很难的，然后再加上外国人学，我觉得会加一个更字儿。我也见过他啊，觉得他的这个身材啊还是很干练的。我觉得这个学武戏应该是对他还抱有希望的，但是就是在练功的过程中呢，可能会，经历一些，苦啊、累啊，啊，希望他能坚持。
所以，现在我做的这个东西，你十一岁的时候
就开始，
哦，
就开始练。
好的，一样的动作，
一样的动作。
所以不管是我在北京、在上海、在美国。都是一样，
对，而且要每天每天的练，
每天。
那我如果明天，我觉得我的腿、我的肌肉都是酸痛，那怎么办？我还继续？
是的，我们叫 疼长酸抽麻不练。疼说明长功了，长功，就是你进步了啊啊，酸或者是麻啊，那个就可以不练了。
OK 啊，对，所以疼没问题，但是酸
对
有问题，
但是你不会酸的。好，那我们继续。
好，这哦，还继续，还要继续，继续
学生。还没学完呢。预备，一、二、三、四、五、六、七。咱们先慢慢来。
二、
好，对，
三，
继
续。三，哦不，的不不，
不是这样，
哎，
是这样，
啊？
这样吗？
我不，
忘了，是这样，这是三吗？
这是三，
对，
五十，
行，对。不行，
哎，五十，
对，
六，
拉开，
六，六十，看
七，
对吧？一二三四的步我记不住。
还要训练什么呀？还要训练眼睛。
哦，眼睛，对。
精气神要看哪儿啊？就要通过眼睛体现。所以尤其是武生在舞台上，眼睛得放光。训练眼睛，我们怎么训练？就通过用云手训练。你再看啊，我们就再增加一步，就是一看看手，二三。四，你看这也是训练眼神了。五，脑袋不动，就动眼睛。六，你看，尤其是最后啊，变脸，其实最关键的啊。看眼睛没有？对，有点硬的。对，这有神了，明白吗？
我明白，但是
做不出来。
对，
没事，你先把眼睛瞪住了。对，七，六。
哎呦，这个是最难的。朱老师 taught me 5 different moves, and at each time I thought this was the hardest, and then came the next one, and the next one was harder, and then came the one after that, and that was even harder. 我很兴奋，因为是我第一天，有可能来明天。我没有这样的啊，
我会帮助你的，我会帮助你的，想尽一切办法。
好，I came in today knowing that I'm gonna leave in pain from the get-go, from the first move. It was not easy at all. It was not enjoyable, I would say. But there's some pleasure that comes out of it, knowing that you can do it. You're not doing it perfectly, but at least you're doing it to the best of your ability. And as Zhu Laosha said, as days go by, it's going to get harder, but it's also going to get better. At the end of the day, I chose to go on this journey. And if it's going to be spent me crying or feeling bad about myself, then what's the point? The whole point is for me to learn something new, and I do want to learn something new, and so it has to be enjoyable. I'm gonna latch onto that whenever I feel that I'm not doing really well, and I think this is just gonna guide me through these 100 days.